Here it is. The Sanhedrin begins to prepare oil to anoint King Messiah. And Kohen Godel, okay, the high priest. So the Sanhedrin has the oil to prepare to anoint the King Messiah and the Third Temple. Okay, this is what we are watching for, the transgression of desolation to give the sanctuary. This is what we are watching for, and it is the Sanhedrin from the Chamber of Hewn Stone, which is part of the Third Temple, that they would issue the decrees from the Chamber of Hewn Stone of the proceedings related to the Third Temple. Now, what they've done with the oil and the preparation of the oil is very, very significant, because they have a different Messiah than we do, but the process is Messiah means to anoint with oil, okay? And Christ, Christos, means anoint, okay? So we have a different Messiah, Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. Now, we told you in a post, Palmoni, 230 days to righteous sanctuary. Okay, now, what happened in here, guys, is it's 2,300 days, as you can see, to cleanse the temple. And you can see in Daniel 9, to anoint the Kodesh Kodeshim, the most holy. So you anoint the king, you anoint the priest, you anoint the temple with anointing oil. That is how you dedicate it. Okay, so it's 2,300 days to cleanse the sanctuary, to anoint the sanctuary. All right, and he said unto me, unto 2,300 days, then the sanctuary shall be cleansed. How do you cleanse the sanctuary? With oil or blood. And there you can see Palmoni, and he is the one that made the statement in Daniel 8:14. Okay, so it was from the time of the daily sacrifice is taken away to the abomination that makes desolate, there will be 1,290 days. Okay, so the host was given against the daily sacrifice on April 30th, 2018, Netanyahu's declaration of war against Iran. So we count those 1,290 days, and we come to the 27th day of the 8th month in the Enoch calendar. Don't worry, that's November 10th, as many of you know. Now, keep in mind, on the Enoch calendar, it's what? The 27th day of the 8th month. Now, the 8th month in Hebrew can be has a couple names. One is Bul, one is Chisvan. And they said it in the article. The temple, the Sanhedrin said the temple and the temple service is the benefit to all nations, said Rabbi Weiss. He said, for that reason, we made the announcement on what? The 27th of Chisvan, the 8th month, which is precisely on the Enoch calendar, the exact date we are looking for. So they said the Christianity especially is susceptible to impurity and is flourishing under idolatry. Christianity must engage in justice, which is the Noahide laws. Okay, so they're declaring the Noahide laws to the Christians. Okay, but in the end of days, those who choose to be part of the temple service will survive. That means those that don't participate in the Noahide laws will be executed, particularly the Christians. Okay? We are now, these are all his quotes, guys. We'll go to the article. We are now entering the time of the preparation of the temple. They're almost complete. They're almost complete, said Raphael Lice. Now is a time for the people to act, to show whether they are part of the temple or against the appearance of God's temple. Okay, injury. So this is our fourth fulfillment, guys, of Daniel's timeline. It started back in July 25th, 2015, the Baphomet statue triggering 790 days, a countdown until the start of the tribulation, which was September 22nd, 2017, with the Revelation 12 sign of the woman clothed with the sun and around her said 12 stars of her, in her crown. Okay, then we had the host given against the daily sacrifice, April 30th, 2018, when Netanyahu declared war against Iran. Then the prophecy says, from the time of the daily sacrifice shall be taken away until the abomination that makes desolate set up, there shall be 1,290 days. So precisely from then, we count forward and we come to November 10th, 2021. 2,300 days until this sanctuary is cleansed. All right, and the Sanhedrin prepares the oil for the king.
Okay, here we are on Israel 365 News, as you can see. And let's look at the article. Sanhedrin begins to prepare the oil to anoint King Messiah, the high priest. Okay, the sacred oil, the compound ingredients of the anointing oil. After exhaustive study, the details surrounding the oil is to anoint the king, Kohen Godel, or high priest, and the kings of Israel. The Sanhedrin is moving forward to prepare enough oil to anoint the Messiah from the house of David, who when he returns, okay, he will rule over Israel in the Messianic era, okay? So the oil is what? For the Messiah. You anoint the Messiah. Messiah means to anoint, okay? Jesus Christos. Christos means anoint, okay? Yeshua Ha Mashiach. Mashiach is Messiah. The anointing oil was described in the Bible used in consecration of the tabernacle. This is what we're saying. After 2,300 days, the temple will be cleansed. How do you cleanse the temple? With oil. Okay? It's the oil. It's the anointing oil. So this is precisely the date we were looking for and the sign that we are on the proper timeline. Make the oil. Okay? Compound. Originally, the oil was used by the priests and the tabernacle articles, but it was then later extended to include the prophets and kings. Okay, so Lord Jesus Christ is king and priest in the order of Melchizedek. So he is both king, priest, and he is the temple. Okay, so we anoint him. Okay, so you can't use it for anything else. He's the ingredients, guys. We have other videos where we talk about the ingredients and the significance. All the ingredients are prepared of total purity. The Sanhedrin has already overseeing the production of the spiritual oil in the temporal menorah, okay? And they talk about the process. It only produces a small amount, okay? And they describe it. You can read the whole article. It's important to note, listen, it's important to note that the oil was called in Hebrew shamen, ha mashaka, okay? Or literally translated as oil, shamen of anointing. The Hebrew word for Messiah, Mashiach, okay, Mashiach, literally is the anointed one, the anointed one. Through this term is also used in the Bible for anyone who has been anointed. So you can anoint the priest, you can anoint the temple, you can anoint the king, you can anoint the prophet, okay? Wise spokesman of Sanhedrin announced the beginning of an anointing oil project last week, appropriately enough, just before the holiday of Hanukkah in a sermon he gave on the Temple Mount. Weiss emphasized the Kohen Godel, the high priest, the temple vessels will be anointed with the temple service begins, which does not actually need a temple, but only the altar. So they dedicated the altar 2018. The temple and the temple service benefit all nations, okay? For that reason, we made the announcement on the 27th day of Chisvan. Okay, guys, this is what we've been saying for, this is November 10th. Okay, on the Enoch calendar, the 27th day of the 8th month is November 10th. This is the same date we've been saying for 6 years to watch for something. 2,300 days, okay, to cleanse the temple. And the temple will be cleansed, all right? The day, okay, when Noah exited the ark and made a sacrifice unto God, at that time God made a covenant to the entire world, promised never again to bring such a catastrophic flood, but also requiring that mankind perform 7 Noahide laws. Now, the Bible doesn't say this, but this is their excuse to execute Christians. Rabbi Weiss noted that this is also the end of the season of harvesting oils and beginning the preparing of the oil. In order for the temple service to return, the nation of Israel must observe these laws, okay? But in order for the nations to take part of this, they must observe the 7 Noahide laws. This is what it says in Revelation 13. Whoever should not worship the beast should be killed. The nations must purify themselves, he explained. All right, this includes the sin of murder and abortion, euthanasia, sexual purity, Christianity. Now, specifically, Christianity is a special subject susceptible to impurity, okay, by idolatry, because they say Jesus Christ is an idol, okay? Because our Mashiach, okay, is forgiven our sins, we are their target, Christianity is acceptable to the seven Noahide laws. They must execute them to their credit. All right, so they talk about kindness. But today a person can choose good or evil. But in the end of days, they must choose to be part of the temple if they will survive. Okay, if you want to live, you have to worship at the temple. And they quote Zechariah 14, all who survive of the nation will come against Jerusalem to in the privilege year by year by the king of the Lord of hosts to observe the Feast of Sukkot. Okay, so that's the Lord Jesus Christ reigning in the millennium in the Ezekiel temple. Okay, but they're saying their Messiah is going to do that. We are now entering the time of the preparation of the temple is almost complete. Now is the time for the people to act and show whether they can be part of the temple. Okay, you have a choice. You can be part of the temple, or you can stand against the reappearance of God's house in Jerusalem and be executed.
To further explain the significance of what just happened to anoint the king Messiah to cleanse the sanctuary, okay, we have to go about the counting of weeks in Daniel chapter 9. So in Daniel chapter 9 says, unto Messiah, 62 weeks, 7 weeks, okay? We know those are years leading to 1,335 days leading to Pentecost, okay? So what happens, guys, is you anoint the sanctuary in heaven. That's what's happened. The heavenly sanctuary is dedicated. Christ is being anointed king and priest, okay? Then it manifests in the earth. So 70 weeks are determined to anoint the most holy. Anoint, Mashiach, most, Kodesh, holy, Kodesh, Kodeshim. So the holy of holies is in the temple. It's in the sanctuary, okay? Daniel 9, 25. Know therefore and understand that from the going forth of the commandment to restore and build Jerusalem unto the Messiah. Okay, so the commandment in the Messiah, okay, Messiah is anointed. Okay, you anoint with oil. So when we come to Passover this year, you count 7 weeks. You come to Pentecost, that's a week. Mount Sinai, that's another week. Then you count another 7 weeks to come to the ninth of Av. Okay, this is a counting of weeks in Daniel. We've been going over these prophecies. Now, if you reverse it and you add the 7 plus the 1 plus the 1 plus the 7, you add 62 weeks. And if you reverse it from the 9th of Av, you come to cleanse the sanctuary. Precisely November 10th, 2,300 days to cleanse the sanctuary when the Sanhedrin begins to prepare to anoint the oil for the King Messiah. I know that's a lot. We'll have further videos to explain this. This is the declaration of the 2,300 days to cleanse the sanctuary. The prophecy was fulfilled for the fourth time. Okay? We'll have more videos on this, guys. Thanks for watching. Definitely check out Daniel's timeline for more details on the prophecy. Thanks for watching, and God bless you.